In the previous lesson, we saw how we can do a VLOOKUP. And I mentioned that the V part of VLOOKUP stands for vertical. Now, we have another lookup function called HLOOKUP. And as you might imagine, the H stands for horizontal. So the difference between HLOOKUP and VLOOKUP is that you use one if your data is organized vertically and the other if your data is organized horizontally. Now, the format that most data is in is vertical. For example, this data set that you can see on this worksheet, this is vertical data. It's where we have our column headings running across the top here, and then we have our rows or our records. And this is by far the most common. But occasionally you will come across a spreadsheet where the data is organized horizontally. So let me show you what that looks like. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab this data set and I'm going to flip it around the other way. So this is also a good opportunity for you to see how to transpose data, which effectively will change the layout. So I'm going to click in my data, Control A to select everything. I'm going to press Control C to copy. I'm just going to go underneath this table, click in a cell, and then I'm going to transpose this data. Now, if we go up to the lower half of the paste button and open up Paste Special, this is where we have our transpose feature. Now, if I click on this and click on OK, it's going to flip that data the other way around. So now you'll notice that we have the column headings in the rows as opposed to in the columns. So we have our titles of our movies running across the row, the year running across the row, so on and so forth. Now, if I wanted to perform a lookup using data that was organized like this, I would need to use HLOOKUP. Because when we use a VLOOKUP, the third argument is the column reference number. So it's asking us to specify the column that we want to return. Now, with HLOOKUP, we need to specify the row that we want to return as opposed to the column. So let's take a look at what that would look like. I'm going to jump across to the HLOOKUP worksheet. And what I want to be able to do here is select a movie from the dropdown list and have it return the year, what it's rated, and the genre. So we're going to start out by creating a data validation dropdown. So let's go to data, click the dropdown next to data validation, and choose data validation from the menu. We want to create a list, and my source for the list I'm going to find on the movie database worksheet. And I'm going to choose the titles of all of the movies. Click on OK. So now I should find that I have a drop-down list that contains all of those movie names. And I can use this to select whichever movie I'm interested in looking at. So now I want to construct an HLOOKUP formula. So let's type in HLOOKUP. And what you'll notice is that the arguments are pretty much exactly the same as when we're using VLOOKUP, except the third argument here is row index number as opposed to col index number. So our lookup value is going to be the film that we select in cell B5, comma, the table array. Now, I haven't named my table, so what I would need to do here is jump across to Movie Database, go down to here, and select the entire table. Now, of course, I can do that, but it's quite a long table, so I'm going to come out of here. Instead of creating a table, I'm going to turn this into a range. So let's click Control A. I'm going to go up to the name box just here, and I'm going to give this range of cells a name, and we're going to call this movies and hit enter, because you can use named ranges in lookup formulas as well. So let's go back to our HLOOKUP. Our lookup value is the movie name, the table array. Well, I want to use the range that I just created. Now, I could start to type in the name of the range. You can see there it is, movies. Alternatively, if you can't remember what you called it, you can press the F3 key and it will show you any named ranges you have in your workbook. So I'm going to select movies. Let's click on OK. Row index number. What row do I want to return? Well, I want to return the year. I can't remember which row that is. Let's quickly jump back across and have a look. So the year is row 2. Let's go back to our formula. Now I'm going to get rid of that HLOOKUP. And we're going to say we want to return the second row, and then we can do an exact or an approximate match. Now I want to exactly match the film name in that range of cells, so we want a false on the end here or 0. Let's hit return, and you can see it's returned the year 2016. And if we change the movie name, so let's do something at the top here, La La Land. Again, that's 2016. Let's check it in the movie database, La La Land, and the year is 2016. Now, with these formulas, you can't necessarily copy these down. You're going to get some NA errors. Because if we take a look at this formula, we can see that it's looking up cell B6, which is currently blank, in the movies table, and it's trying to return row 2 again. So this isn't correct. So if we escape out of there, I could make this a little bit better by locking the cell reference B5 in the formula so it doesn't move. So let's do that. Let's press F4. Hit enter. Now it's still not going to work properly because it's returning row number 2 every single time. But I could simply go in, edit these formulas and change the row. So we're looking for rated and genre. So rated is row 3 and genre is row 6. So I'm very quickly just going to come into this formula. We'll update this row number to 3 and we'll update this row number to 6. So now when I change this to something else, we get all of the results that we're looking for. So that's the difference between VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. It really does just relate to the way you have your data organized on your page.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.